Howdy, BCTVites. Welcome back to another edition of BCTV's weekly interactive video calendar, released each Thursday at youtube.com/BrattleBroTV and BrattleBroTV.org. It's all sponsored by the Brattleboro Savings and Loan and gives me a chance to take a look at the weekend's upcoming events for the area with you. By standing up here in front of BCTV's interactive video wall at any point during my chit-chatting away here, just click one of those gray buttons behind me with the black and white arrow link icons on them, like this one right here. And that'll take you to an official organizer website, get you all the where's and when's details on involving yourself in any one of these events. We'll start on Thursday, March 6th, today, tonight. In fact, as Brattleboro Area Hospice gets set to kick off their weekly open forum series, this is a series of discussions on end-of-life care. It's open to the public. They kick off at 6:30 at the Gathering Place each Thursday, including this Thursday, where Joanna Reuter, who's an advanced care planning coach, trained hospice volunteer, and the owner of Sustainable Aging, will lead the workshop. For more, we've got spotlight video from the last time Joanna was here in our downtown studios.
When you're living in a home setting, we have seen a real trend towards financial exploitation, drug diversion, you know, things that you wouldn't necessarily see if someone were being more closely supervised.
Before we move on to talk Women's Film Festival here in Brattleboro, Brooks Memorial Library hosts each and every Friday at noon a Know Your Library tours and tips open session for both advanced library users and beginners. This week it's led by reference librarian Jean Walsh and is every first Friday of the month, again at noon at Brooks Memorial Library. All right, with that we'll move on and talk Women's Film Festival 2014. It's all getting set to kick off this weekend. Now for an intricate schedule that's far more detailed than what we could block out on the calendar here, you'll have to click the button or head to womensfilmfestivalalloneword.org. But I can tell you all these films are going to be screened at the New England Youth Theater. All proceeds benefit the Women's Freedom Center in Brattleboro. For more, let's take a look at a spotlight video, see some of the trailers that are coming up, and find out more about the festival.
The gun carries with it the baggage of violence. I mean, it is an object to maim and kill with.
Guns are symbols of male power, male authority. Women aren't burdened with all that stuff. We don't have any masculinity.
Before we say adieu to this calendar, local sensations My Gay Banjo returns fresh off the success of their recent album and tour. They're going to be playing the Root Social Justice Center this coming Saturday night at 8 p.m. Sliding scale for tickets at the door, so be sure to check that out or head to their own link on Facebook here. Again, My Gay Banjo. And there's one more button to click if you're interested. It's that one in the far corner over there that says Your Event Here. That's how you can find out how to get your area nonprofit organization and or event listed as part of BCTV's video calendar, maybe even get me to chit-chat away about it as well. So be sure to click that link as well. It'll take you to the landing page for the video calendar at BCTV's official website, BrattleBroTV.org. And as I continue to shamelessly promote BCTV here, as the episode for this week wraps up, that means there's still time to click any one of these links behind me, find out more about events, find out which movies you might want to see as part of the Women's Film Festival, and much, much more. So be sure to check that out. Or catch us tomorrow at Friday's 5:45 p.m. on BCTV Comcast Channel 8 as part of 5:45 Live, our weekly media roundup. And of course, another edition next Thursday when we return for a new YouTube upload of BCTV's video calendar. In the meantime, thanks for watching. We'll see you next week.